Sa mga hindi ko po nakaka-subscribe sa aking YouTube channel, please like, subscribe, and pakiclick na rin po ang notification bell para updated po kayo sa aking mga bagong video. Please watch this video.
Villa del Rey, the chief accountant of the office of the vice president.
Mr. Chair,
Mr. Chair, point of clarification,
so that before we rule on the motion.
Okay, before we rule, what is the point of Honorable Roj?
Mr. Chair, may we know from the, just so that we know how to decide on the motion if we will agree with it or to object. Mr. Chair, I understand there were two names mentioned, but yung isa po si Ms. Gina Acosta, may we know from the COMSEC if she was already invited?
COMSEC?
Yes, thank you, Your Honor. No, she was not invited. We were not informed that she was a special disbursing officer, Your Honor. So she is also not in the website, Your Honor. Of the
Those two names were not invited yet?
Yes, Your Honor, not invited. Ms. Gina F. Acosta, the special disbursing officer, and Ms. Julieta Villa del Rey, the chief accountant of the Office of the Vice President.
Thank you then, Mr. Chair. In that case, I will join the motion of the Honorable Castro. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Is there any second to the motion?
Second, Chairman. Chairman.
Is there any objection?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Congressman Paduano.
Before the Chairman rules with regards to the motion being made by the Honorable Franz Castro, let me ask the Chairman. Since we invited to the motion of the Honorable Castro, a certain Ms. Acosta and Villa del Rey, Julieta, Mr. Chairman, can we ask if, kasi po, if we invite those resource persons or witnesses, no, resource persons or witnesses, we should have a basis for them to be invited. Now, as far as I know, during the appropriations budget deliberation with regards to the budget of the Office of the Vice President, the name of the two officials from the OBP was mentioned. But I hope, Mr. Chairman, there's a record with regards to what really transpired during the budget deliberation of the appropriations. And with that, Mr. Chairman, let me also ask for the Committee on Appropriations to submit in this committee just purposes of record and to justify the motion being made by the Honorable Franz Castro for them to submit through the Appropriations Committee, through the Chair, Chairman Saldico, the excerpts and the documents submitted to the committee with regards to the justification for the presence of the two officials of the OBP in the next hearing, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Noted. We will inform the COMSEC to please take note of the manifestation of the Honorable Paduano. In the meantime, we will rule on the motion of the Honorable Franz Castro. Is there any objection? Hearing none, the motion is carried.
May I proceed, Mr. Chair?
The Honorable Raul Manuel, hindi po minus yung inyong oras. You still have...
Sige,
you still have 4 minutes.
Okay, thank
you. Please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, nabanggit po kanina na hindi qualified sa paggamit ng confidential funds ng Office of the Vice President for 2022 ang medical and food aid. Can we confirm this from the Commission on Audit?
As of yung AOM po namin, since medical...
COA, please wait to be recognized by the chair. Attorney Camora, you are recognized. And please address your answer to the chair.
Mr. Chair, since as of the review of the documents, we have deemed them not qualified as confidential expenses since they just indicated food and medical supplies as is.
Mr. Chair, how much po yung amount na dineclare ng OVP na pinagamitan di umano ng medical and food aid?
Mr. Chair, anong period po?
for 2022, yung confidential funds?
For 2022, it was 35 million for supplies.
For medical and food aid.
For medical and supplies, Mr. Chair, 40 million pesos.
Sa pagtingin natin, Mr. Chair, bagamat syempre gusto natin na makatulong ang ating mga ahensya ng gobyerno, mapagbuti yung pag-provide ng mga services, pero tingin natin, Mr. Chair, ay questionable nga kung kukunin sa confidential funds ang pag-provide ng medical and food aid. Lalo na't supposedly nga transparent, magkano talaga yung nagagastos para dyan, tapos sa bawat beneficiary din, magkano yung worth ng kanilang nakukuha, ilan din yung beneficiaries. E di ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, delikado kapag yung ganitong mga tipo ng serbisyo ay ang magiging source natin ano ay confidential funds. Sa experience po ba, Mr. Chair, ng Commission on Audit, meron din ba dating mga agencies ng pamahalaan na nag-declare na gumamit sila ng confidential funds para sa medical and food aid?
Kowa, please answer.
Mr. Chair, we have not come across, or kung meron man, Mr. Chair, it has not been under my audit po.
So,
may iba po kasing auditors.
May ibang? Pakilakasan po yung inyong boses.
May ibang auditors po. So, hindi lang po kami. Opo. So, I am not aware if may mga ibang agencies po na nagde-declare ng medical and food supplies.
Okay, so Mr. Chair, ibig sabihin hindi standard practice na ang pantulong sa ating mga kababayan ay kinukuha siya mula sa confidential funds. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Koa, please answer.
Tama po, Mr. Chair, pero I would like to point out po sa joint circular that supplies, materials are actually allowed, except that you have to identify them as used in confidential activities like surveillance activities. Yan lang po, Mr. Chair.
So, ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, under our current rules, meron siyang qualifier pero hindi absolute na ibig sabihin kung based lang sa personal na kagustuhan ng opisyal ay gagamitin niya yung confidential funds para sa medical and food aid. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Yes, Mr. Chair. As long as the rent, purchase or rental of supplies, materials, and equipment are for confidential operations, they will comply with the joint circular po.
Okay. Mr. Chair, kasunod naman, na-mention din kanina na walang bagong submission ang Office of the Vice President regarding doon sa Notice of Disallowance. Can the Commission on Audit expound on that, Mr. Chair? Kasi nga, ang dating kasi sa ilan sa mga kababayan natin ay as if ba hindi nabibigyan ng pagkakataon ang OVP para talaga ipaliwanag, tapos after the notice of disallowance na actually ang nais nun, Mr. Chair, ay pinapabalik sa OVP yung hindi maipaliwanag na paggastos ng confidential fund. So para lang po talaga malinaw, Mr. Chair, nabigyan ng pagkakataon ng OVP to explain, and meron po bang mga latest na submissions ang OVP on top of those na naipasa niya na dati?
Mr. Chair, if it pertains to the 2022 confidential fund,
yes, Mr. Chair,
wala pa pong actually hindi na po sila required mag-reply sa amin since it's already a notice of disallowance. Their remedy na po is either settlement or appeal the notice of disallowance po.
Okay. So, Mr. Chair, ibig sabihin, para po maunawaan na ating mga kababayan, may pinapabalik na confidential funds na ginamit ng Office of the Vice President noong 2022. Ang options ay ibalik yon or umapela. And kung strong naman po yung appeal at ibig sabihin ay kakayaning ma-justify, edi pwedeng hindi pabalikin. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Tama po. Depende po sa decision ng commission proper, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So kung doon sa second option, Mr. Chair, na umapela, meron bang mga pinasa na mga dokumento ang Office of the Vice President para po formally sila na makapag-appeal para hindi sila require na ibalik yung confidential funds na na-flag? Meron po bang naipasa, Mr. Chair?
Wala po kaming information, Mr. Chair, kung nakapag-file po sila ng appeal nila. It's with the commission proper na po, so hindi na po sa ICFAO yun fina-file.
So Mr. Chair, do we have a representative from the Commission on Audit mismo? Labas pa dun sa ICFAO. Meron po ba dito, Mr. Chair? So we can get the response from them, Mr. Chair.
We have here the representative from government audit sector, Mr. Fahad bin Tomawis. Could you respond to the query of the Honorable Manuel?
Good morning, Mr. Chair. Please be informed that I'm not in the position to answer the question because I'm the audit team leader of the regular audit of the OBP. For the confidential fund, it is part of the ICFAO, and for the appeal, it is part of the commission proper of the Commission on Audit. So it must be addressed to the commission proper of the Commission on Audit.
Mr. Chair, meron po ba taga-commission
proper? May I ask the COMSEC if she invited the representative of COA?
Mr. Chair, there's an office that monitors the filing of an appeal, which is the Commission Secretariat Office. So on the question on whether there's an appeal that has been filed by the OVP, we will validate on that.
Mr. Chair,
please do so.
Yes.
Kailangan din nating malaman no, dito sa komite, how long po yung duration para ma-verify po at ma-check yung ganong impormasyon.
Attorney.
Mr. Chair, the OPP has 180 days to file an appeal. So we will wait for that within that period, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so Mr. Chair, kailan po nag-start ang pagbibilang ng 180 days or nearly 6 months?
Sino pong sasagot?
Mr. Chair,
Attorney Camora, you're recognized.
Sorry. Mr. Chair, it runs from the receipt of the OVP of the ND, which is per our record, it was on August 9, 2024.
Okay, so ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, aabangan natin ang magiging aksyon. Nonetheless, Mr. Chair,
Please wrap up your question.
Yes, Mr. Chair, thank you. Para lang maliwanag talaga at hindi po nadidisinform ang ating mga kababayan, ibig sabihin po, ang merong dapat na proactive na ginagawa para maghabol at ipaliwanag kung paano ginamit yung confidential funds ay ang OVP po talaga. Hindi po pwedeng linlangin yung ating mga kababayan na it is the burden of other offices, other officials na mag-present po ng mga ebidensya. Kasi in fact, ang sabi na nga po ng COA, kung hindi mag-aapela, dapat po talaga ibalik ang hindi maipaliwanag na paggastos ng confidential funds. Yun lang po, Mr. Chair. Maraming salamat.
Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, before I recognize the next interpellator, the Honorable Paduano, you're
Thank
recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Germane to the question asked by Congressman Manuel. To the COA, now, the Office of the Vice President made an appeal. Okay? Now, ang question, timeline po tayo. Timeline. So, an appeal will be discussed dun sa director, then commission proper. How long will it take? Yung Kowa. Appeal.
Sino
how long
inyo?
Will it take?
Kowa. Attorney Camora.
Mr. Chair, may I ask
the appeal.
A repetition? The appeal is...
How long will it take?
They are given 180 days po. From
tama, 180 days.
Yes, Mr.
So,
Chair.
So, within 6 months.
Yes, Mr.
And
Chair.
And after that, after the 180 days, which is 6 months...
Ang tanong po ni Congressman Paduano, after the appeal, gaano po ninyo katagal bago sagutin or maglabas po kayo ng recommendation?
Sandali po. Chairman, kasi the appeal, the any office, no, for that matter, and in this case, the office of the Vice President is given 180 days or 6 months from the appeal. Now, so, bibigyan sila ng 6 months. And now, for example, the appeal supposedly started when the NDA, no, notice of disallowance started January. So, ang appeal niya, no, appeal niya will be pwedeng June 30. Tama? On that year. Tama? Last day, for example, of that 180 days. Tama?
Yes, Mr.
Chair. Then again, after the appeal, iakyat sa commission paper.
Mr. Chair, the appeal is filed before the commission proper, Mr. Chair.
So, hindi na dadaan doon sa director. Diretso na po sa commission proper.
Hindi na po.
Okay, now, upon the receipt of the commission paper, how long will it take for the appeal, for the commission paper to decide?
Under our rules, Mr. Chair, 60 days po. But,
Sorry, 60 days.
Yes.
That's 2 months. Okay. But what, please?
But the commission proper may release its decision beyond the 60 days, considering the peculiarity of the case and, of course, the appreciation of the submitted documents, Your Honor.
So, you're telling the peculiarity of the case in the case of the Office of the Vice President is so peculiar? That is why that will go beyond the 60 days? Are you saying that?
Your Honor, actually, what the rules prescribe is 60 days.
Yun ang rules, yes. Di ba? Now, Mr. Chairman, just sa mga short manifestation, eto ngayon, ang problema. Kasi we are conducting this inquiry in aid of legislation because we have to have a legislative action in this case. Again, part of my manifestation, Mr. Chair, we have to review that 180 days. Because that is too long. Kasi, pwede kasi mangyari talaga na last day of that 180 days, sa kanila, sagutin yung appeal. Diba, magpadala ng appeal. Then after that, under the rules, is another 60 days. And it will take 8 months, Mr. Chairman. That's why, again, it was already discussed in the previous hearing in my committee. And I want to appeal to the COA to please have an amendment on such, because that is not a law. That is just a policy, an IRR of the COA. And Mr. Chairman, allow me to discuss furthermore later. But as of now, Mr. Chairman, I would like to manifest that iyon po ang problema ng COA. Because 180 days and another 60 days, it's too long to give justice to the funds being appropriated by any agency. I'm not just pointing to the Office of the Vice President. It happens even in any agency and even with regards to the case under my committee. In the case of Mamba, no, Governor Mamba, until now the COA has not yet submitted its final report. That's why, again, I'm appealing to the COA. Last year pa to po, last year budget niyo pa. And hopefully, bukas nakasala kayo, di ba? Kaya lang may quadcom ako bukas. Kasi kung wala akong quadcom, sisingilin ko ulit kayo because this issue has been taking too long since last year pa, Mr. Chairman. And that's, as of now, Mr. Chairman, I end my manifestation and I will proceed later with the specifics with regards to the issue about the co-audit report of the Office of the Vice President. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you po. We will now recognize the Honorable Vice Chairman, J. Kong-hun.
Just a statement, Mr. Chair. The purpose of this inquiry is not to attack anyone, but to shed light on matters that affect our nation's governance. Refusing to testify under oath sends a signal that there is something to avoid. If there is nothing to conceal, why not take the oath? It is the basic act of accountability that all public officials must be willing to undertake. When a public official refuses to take an oath, it opens the questions about the truthfulness of their statement. Taking the oath is not just a legal formality, it is a commitment to honesty. Any refusal to do so undermines trust in public statements. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Honorable Jay Kong-hun. Yes, Honorable Lara.
Chair, just a manifestation also with regards to COA. Relative dun sa binanggit ni Chairman Paduano, considering na lahat ng mga investigation natin when it comes to public funds, ang number one na kailangan natin is the COA. No? Kasi alam naman natin ang role ng COA dito. So, ang ano ko lang, sa lahat, nabanggit niya yung Mamba case and others. Palagi ang germane na issue here is the duration from which na-finalize nyo yung report ninyo. So, eto from your end, no, Mr. Chair, sana maparating ito kay Chairman ng COA once and for all, no, na yung you try to review yung mga policies na finormulate ninyo. No, kasi ito sa mga pagdinig namin, no, ang the whole COA process from the time na magkaroon ng audit to AOM to notice of disallowance to the filing of proper cases, palagi niyong tandaan na Mr. Chair, on the part of COA, yung dokumento talaga na manggagaling sa kanila is a very, very crucial. If not, yun yung talagang magdidiin kung meron talagang paglabag sa lahat na ito. Katulad ng issues natin ngayon, no, dito sa pinag-uusapan natin ngayon. So, ito po, with due respect sa COA, no, yung mga you should also take in consideration all the processes, notwithstanding the dilatory tactics that causes the delay. No, kasi katulad nito, 180 days bibigyan nyo from which to appeal. Baka meron ulit ito, isasubmit ulit, no, na mag-i-issue ng o mag-sisik ng another extension of time na pinagbibigyan ninyo. So, ito, just to manifest, Mr. Chair, if it would be formulated and legislated, itong mga ganitong mga bagay in terms of duration, kasi alam naman natin ang purpose, number one purpose ng lahat ng pagdinig natin dito sa Kongreso is in aid of legislation, no? Para hindi na maulit ito, kung pwede, mapaiksian natin, no, itong mga duration, in terms of duration, no?
Disappointed po tayo. Actually, kasabay ng hearing na ito sa Committee on Good Government ay ang plenary debate sa budget for 2025. Mr. Chair, tayo and of course yung mga colleagues natin, we took the time for this committee at inimbitahan ng Office of the Vice President. Pero yun nga po, nalaman natin na hindi po nag-take ng oath at ayun, bago po tayo makapagtanong para din po sana marinig ng nakaupong Vice Presidente, eh, umalis na rin po, Mr. Chair. And actually, when I recalled yung mga ibang pwedeng presidents din natin, Mr. Chair, while nabanggit po na merong right, no, yung, or may option ang mga public officials na hindi po mag-oath pero hindi naman po all the time na ganun yung ginagawa. Even yung mga former presidents nga po, Mr. Chair, like former President Ramos, former President Estrada, former President Noynoy Aquino, ay dumalo nung inibitahan din sila sa mga legislative inquiry at nag-take po sila ng oath, Mr. Chair. And I'm also wondering, Mr. Chair, kung meron din po bang dumalo, maliban po sa sitting Vice President, other personnel po from the OVP na nandito, meron po ba, Mr. Chair?
Wala po.
Pero di ba, Mr. Chair, I believe we sent invitations hindi lang sa sitting Vice President, pero maging sa iba pang mga nagtitake ng major function sa OVP. So, Mr. Chair, we have afforded several opportunities for the OVP actually, hindi lang sa ating formal budget hearings, pero maging sa Committee on Good Government, Mr. Chair. So, I think again, we can let the Filipino people judge, no, kung ano ba talaga ang performance ng mga niluklok nating mga opisyal sa pamahalaan. So, ang tatanungin ko na lang, Mr. Chair, ay ang COA. Sa COA ko po
interjection, Mr. Chair.
Yes, the Honorable Franz Castro.
Yes, so, since the Vice President did not take the oath, no, and I think wala naman siyang sasabihin kung tatanungin natin. So, buti na lang na umalis na siya. Well, next meeting, Mr. Chair, pwede ba nating imbitahin from the Office of the Vice President? Dahil sila yung mga pumirma, no, doon sa mga liquidation. Miss Gina Acosta, Special Disbursing Officer from the Office of the Vice President. Miss Julieta Villa del Rey, the Chief Accountant of the Office of the Vice President, to give us light, no, doon sa mga na-disburse, na naobliga nila at saka yung mga receipt na ipinasa nila sa COA. Can we do that, Mr. Chair? This is a motion, Mr. Chair.
Yes po. There is a motion by the Honorable Franz Castro to invite the following resource persons. Number one, Gina Acosta of the Office of the Vice President and Julieta Villa del Rey, the Chief Accountant of the Office of the Vice President.
Mr. Chair?
Is there...
Mr. Chair, point of clarification lang. So that before we rule on the motion.
Okay, before we rule, what is the point of Honorable Roj?
Mr. Chair, may we know from the, just so that we know how to decide on the motion if we will agree with it or to object. Mr. Chair, my understanding, I understand there were two names mentioned, but yung isa po si Ms. Gina Acosta, may we know from the COMSEC if she was already invited?
COMSEC?
Yes, thank you, Your Honor. No, she was not invited. We were not informed that she was a special disbursing officer, Your Honor. So she is also not in the website, Your Honor. Of the
so
OVP.
Those two names were not invited yet?
Yes, Your Honor, not okay. Invited. Ms. Gina F. Acosta, the special disbursing officer, and Ms. Julieta Villa del Rey, the chief accountant of the Office of the Vice President.
Thank you then, Mr. Chair. In that case, I will join the motion of the Honorable Castro. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Is there any second to the motion?
Second, Chairman. Chairman.
Okay. Is there any objection?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Congressman Paduano.
Before the Chairman rules with regards to the motion being made by the Honorable Franz Castro, let me ask the Chairman. Since we invited to the motion of the Honorable Castro, a certain Ms. Acosta and Villa del Rey, Julieta, Mr. Chairman, can we ask if, kasi po, if we invite those resource persons or witnesses, no, resource persons or witnesses, we should have a basis for them to be invited. Now, as far as I know, during the appropriations budget deliberation with regards to the budget of the Office of the Vice President, the name of the two officials from the OBP was mentioned. But I hope, Mr. Chairman, there's a record with regards to what really transpired during the budget deliberation of the appropriations. And with that, Mr. Chairman, let me also ask, no, for the Committee on Appropriations to submit in this committee just purposes of record and to justify the motion being made by the Honorable Franz Castro for them to submit, no, through the Appropriations Committee, through the chair, Chairman Saldico, the excerpts and the documents submitted to the committee with regards to the justification for the presence of the two officials of the OBP in the next hearing, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Noted. We will inform the COMSEC to please take note of the manifestation of the Honorable Paduano. In the meantime, we will rule on the motion of the Honorable Franz Castro. Is there any objection? Hearing none, the motion is carried. The,
may I proceed, Mr.
The,
Chair?
The Honorable Raul Manuel, hindi po minus yung inyong oras. You still have...
Sige.
You still have 4 minutes.
Okay, thank
Please
you.
Please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, nabanggit po kanina na hindi qualified sa paggamit ng confidential funds ng Office of the Vice President for 2022 ang medical and food aid. Can we confirm this from the Commission on Audit?
As of yung AOM po namin, since medical...
COA, please wait to be recognized by the Chair. Attorney Camora, you are recognized. And please address your answer to the Chair.
Mr. Chair, since as of the review of the documents, we have deemed them not qualified as confidential expenses since they just indicated food and medical supplies as is.
Mr. Chair, how much po yung amount na dineclare ng OVP na pinagamitan di umano ng medical and food aid?
Mr. Chair, anong period po?
For 2022, yung confidential funds.
For 2022, it was 35 million for supplies.
For medical and
for
food
medical
aid.
And supplies, Mr. Chair, 40
million pesos. Sa pagtingin natin, Mr. Chair, bagamat syempre gusto natin na makatulong ang ating mga ahensya ng gobyerno, mapagbuti yung pag-provide ng mga services, pero tingin natin, Mr. Chair, ay questionable nga kung kukunin sa confidential funds ang pag-provide ng medical and food aid. Lalo na't supposedly nga transparent, magkano talaga yung nagagastos para dyan, tapos sa bawat beneficiary din, magkano yung worth ng kanilang nakukuha, ilan din yung beneficiaries. E di ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, delikado kapag yung ganitong mga tipo ng serbisyo ay ang magiging source natin ano ay confidential funds. Sa experience po ba, Mr. Chair, ng Commission on Audit, meron din ba dating mga agencies ng pamahalaan na nag-declare na gumamit sila ng confidential funds para sa medical and food aid?
Kowa, please answer.
Mr. Chair, we have not come across, or kung meron man, Mr. Chair, it has not been under my audit po.
So,
may iba po kasing auditors.
May ibang? Pakilakasan po yung inyong boses.
May ibang auditors po. So, hindi lang po kami. Opo. So, I am not aware if may mga ibang agencies po na nagde-declare ng medical and food supplies.
Okay, so Mr. Chair, ibig sabihin hindi standard practice na ang pantulong sa ating mga kababayan ay kinukuha siya mula sa confidential funds. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Koa, please answer.
Tama po, Mr. Chair, pero I would like to point out po sa joint circular that supplies, materials are actually allowed except that you have to identify them as used in confidential activities like surveillance activities. Yun lang po, Mr. Chair.
So, ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, under our current rules, meron siyang qualifier pero hindi absolute na Ibig sabihin, kung based lang sa personal na kagustuhan ng opisyal, ay gagamitin niya yung confidential funds para sa medical and food aid. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Yes, Mr. Chair. As long as the rent, purchase or rental of supplies, materials, and equipment are for confidential operations, they will comply with the joint circular po.
Okay. Mr. Chair, kasunod naman, na-mention din kanina na walang bagong submission ang Office of the Vice President regarding nga doon sa notice of disallowance. Can the Commission on Audit expound on that, Mr. Chair? Kasi nga, ang dating kasi sa ilan sa mga kababayan natin ay as if ba hindi nabibigyan ng pagkakataon ang OVP para talaga ipaliwanag, tapos after the notice of disallowance na actually ang nais nun, Mr. Chair, ay pinapabalik sa OVP yung hindi maipaliwanag na paggastos ng confidential fund. So para lang po talaga malinaw, Mr. Chair, nabigyan ng pagkakataon ng OVP to explain, and meron po bang mga latest na submissions ang OVP on top of those na naipasa niya na dati?
Mr. Chair, if it pertains to the 2022 confidential fund,
yes, Mr. Chair.
Wala pa pong actually hindi na po sila required mag-reply sa amin since it's already a notice of disallowance. The remedy na po is either settlement or appeal the notice of disallowance po.
Okay. So, Mr. Chair, ibig sabihin, para po maunawaan nating mga kababayan, may pinapabalik na confidential funds na ginamit ng Office of the Vice President noong 2022. Ang options ay ibalik yon or umapela. And kung strong naman po yung appeal at ibig sabihin ay kakayaning ma-justify, edi pwedeng hindi pabalikin. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Tama po. Depende po sa decision ng Commission proper, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So kung doon sa second option, Mr. Chair, na umapela, meron bang mga pinasa na mga dokumento ang Office of the Vice President para po formally sila na makapag-appeal para hindi sila require na ibalik yung confidential funds na na-flag? Meron po bang naipasa, Mr. Chair?
Wala po kaming information, Mr. Chair, kung nakapag-file po sila ng appeal nila. It's with the commission proper na po, so hindi na po sa ICFA yun fina-file.
So Mr. Chair, do we have a representative from the Commission on Audit mismo labas pa dun sa ICFA? Meron po ba dito, Mr. Chair? So we can get the response from them, Mr. Chair.
We have here the representative from government audit sector, Mr. Fahad bin Tomawis. Could you respond to the query of the Honorable Manuel?
Good morning, Mr. Chair. Please be informed that I'm not in the position to answer the question because I'm the audit team leader of the regular audit of the OBP. For the confidential fund, it is part of the ICFAO, and for the appeal, it is part of the commission proper of the Commission on Audit. So it must be addressed to the commission proper of the Commission on Audit.
Mr. Chair, may I
ask the COMSEC if she invited the representative of OWA?
Mr. Chair, there's an office that monitors the filing of an appeal, which is the Commission Secretariat Office. So on the question on whether there's an appeal that has been filed by the OVP, we will validate on that.
Mr. Chair,
please do so.
Yes.
Kailangan din nating malaman, no, dito sa komite, how long po yung duration para ma-verify po at ma-check yung ganong impormasyon.
Attorney.
Mr. Chair, the OPP has 180 days to file an appeal. So we will wait for that within that period, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so Mr. Chair, kailan po nag-start ang pagbibilang ng 180 days or nearly 6 months?
Sino pong
Mr.
sasagot?
Chair,
Attorney Camora, you're recognized.